أكبر الله أكبر
Islam, the world's fastest growing religion.
لا إله إلا الله.
A statistic mirrored in Australia's indigenous population. In 2001, there were just over 600 indigenous Muslims. Today, more than 1,000 are practicing. One of them is Eddie Davis. His spiritual quest began more than 30 years ago after losing his mother.
For me, Islam is the answer to reunite our people. But too much has been lost, and it's not our fault. We didn't lose it. It was taken from us for the most part, forced into Christianity, or had our belief systems broken down deliberately.
When Aboriginal Muslims are mentioned, the name of world champion boxer and ex-rugby league star Anthony Mundine inevitably comes up. For the author of Islam Dreaming, this was the first and hardest hurdle to overcome.
It took a lot of persuading to make people believe that, you know, there was actually enough material to write a book, let alone any Aboriginal people beyond Anthony Mundine.
What she found was a rich and long history of Aboriginal association with Islam, predating the arrival of Europeans.
Well before Captain Cook landed here, there were fishermen from Makassar, which is in the Sulawesi in Indonesia, who used to travel down in their boats to the north and northwestern coastlines of Australia, the Arnhem Land and Kimberley coasts, in search of a sea slug called tripang.
The Afghan Cameleers, who established the railways, and the predominantly Muslim Malay pearl divers also forged close relationships with Aboriginal people.
I can be Muslim and I can be Aboriginal and I can be a woman and I can be Chinese all at the same time. And people seem to find that a really difficult concept to understand.
We also had this kind of dual life happening where we were Muslim girls also, but then at the same time we were Aboriginal bush girls that had to know what to do on the land.